Last season, Everton and Aston Villa both had excellent campaigns. They were the two teams tucked in just behind the big four. And there were people saying this season they even stood a chance of challenging the likes of Arsenal, Chelsea and Manchester City for a place at the top table. That hasn't quite materialised. Everton, though, will be very eager here to find some form with the Merseyside derby coming at Goodison next. And Aston Villa arrive looking to restore their pride after a 4-0 demolition in the Conti Cup semi-final defeat to Arsenal. Everton with the opportunity to do the treble over Aston Villa this season, having beaten them pretty soundly in the FA Cup match in January. And there was also the league win that came earlier on in the campaign. Carla Ward's team, I'm sure, will be eager to prevent that. Well, here at Walton Hall Park, we can have a look at the teams. And we'll start with the home team, Everton. Well, they've struggled for goals this season, Everton, having scored the fewest in the league. Aurora Garley won the Barclays Women's Super League Goal of the Month, though, for February. And Everton did manage to put three past Aston Villa in the FA Cup win in January. Katia Snuis scoring twice that day, and she starts. And for Aston Villa, goalkeeper Van Domselaar has a hip injury, and so Anna Leet, who conceded four in the Conti Cup semi-final defeat, starts again here. Kirsty Hansen picked up a calf injury in that game. Ebony Salmon replaces her, making just her second start in the Barclays Women's Super League this season. And 27, Alyssa Stenivic. Everton substitutes 13, Libby Hart, 11. Well, Everton have certainly had their problems here at home at Walton Hall Park. And across the campaign in all of their home matches, they have won only one home match. Although that did come fairly recently against West Ham. Something they'll be looking to build on here. Both of these teams hit by pretty significant injuries across the campaign, and that's definitely reflected in the two teams here today. Everton will continue to play a rather makeshift looking back three. Justine Van Avermaet, not normally known for being a defender, but she's had to fill in there recently. Aston Villa, meanwhile, well, it remains to be seen exactly how they will line up here. Rachel Corsi has been a mainstay of the Aston Villa team more recently, but she starts today on the bench. Changes for Carla Ward. Some enforced as well, with Van Domselaar and Hansen both out of the lineup. Two familiar captains, two leaders, Finnegan and Daly. And it will be Daly here, the England international, who will get us started. No, maybe it won't. Ebony Salmon instead. Ebony Salmon gets us started then here. Aston Villa and Carla Ward's side looking for a quick response after that Conti Cup semi-final defeat against Arsenal. Aston Villa were unable to cope with the relentless energy in the early stages from Arsenal for very quick first half goals. Aston Villa looking for a quick start here. And here is Daly feeding the ball through. Normally the scorer of goals for Aston Villa, looking to turn provider, feeds it through. It's picked up by the Republic of Ireland international Courtney Brosnan, who is in goal today for Everton, and she will find captain Finnegan, who will play at the heart of Aston Villa's back three here. Van Avermaet in that unfamiliar position on the right-hand side of defence, although it is a position that she's covered more recently. And here is Bennison, Swedish international. having more of a role to play in the first team more recently. Scored a brilliant goal against Manchester City in the Barclays Women's Super League. Anna Leet, the New Zealand international in goal today for Aston Villa, covering for Van Domselaar. She picked up an injury, although there have been significant rumours about Van Domselaar and what might happen for her next. Arsenal apparently interested in her services for next season. Good pressure by Everton. Lucy Hope back in the starting 11. And was right on Maz Pacheco, who has started on the left-hand side of defence. Looks as though Ebony Salmon will play on the left-hand side as a direct replacement for Kirsty Hansen. Anna Leet with a risky pass, but it's swept away well by Patton. Aston Villa pass themselves away from danger. Up there with the best atmospheres that you'll hear in the Barclays Women's Super League here at Walton Hall Park. Everton fans really get behind their team, and they continue to grow in number. Good progression being made here by Aston Villa. Salmon will go for goal. Sees the effort blocked, and Aston Villa will have to start again here on the halfway line with Patton. Has started all 16 games now in the Barclays Women's Super League for Aston Villa. Patton, the only player in Aston Villa's starting 11 to do that. Daly looking to lift one over the top. Daly with a touch. Daly's touch in towards Adriana Leon is intercepted. Everton defensively very sound. Has been at the other end that they've had their problems this season. They have scored the fewest in the Barclays Women's Super League, only 13 goals across the campaign so far for Everton. And that really has been the issue. Creating chances, scoring goals. Piemonte here, who was brought in to change that in the summer, maybe hasn't made the impact that Everton were hoping. 14 in 24 games last season for AC Milan in Italy. Just the two so far in the Barclays Women's Super League for Piemonte. Aston Villa very nearly caught out, and they still might be. Patton has managed to turn away. Noel Moritz continues to deputise as a centre-back. It's a role that she's had to play a couple of times over recent weeks because of the injuries at the back for Aston Villa. She was cup-tied for the Arsenal semi-final match, the Conti Cup semi-final match. Back into the lineup here, Noel Moritz. And her clearance away, ricochets off of Piemonte, and the danger is averted. Leet making just her second Barclays Women's Super League appearance of the season. Also started the 1-0 win against Brighton earlier on in the campaign, so one appearance, one clean sheet so far for her. Was a bit more difficult against Arsenal last time out, but Leonardo Marnham and Blackstenius were in pretty scintillating form. Garley, who has been having some season two spectacular goals across the campaign, one against Manchester City and then perhaps one that was even better against West Ham. Two contenders for goal of the season. Here comes Piemonte. She'll go wide towards Hope. Bennison trying to turn, but she's got Jordan Nobbs for company here. Here is Hope again, trying to squeeze the ball through. She was looking for the run of Kuhl, unable to combine though with the Danish international. Perhaps the best attacking build-up of the game so far for Everton. Doesn't come to too much though. Passed away by the Aston Villa defence. The pressure is still on though here. Garley looking for a teammate. Kuhl's looking to get there. Unable to control the ball. Pressure on for Mayling now. Snuis robs possession. Piemonte can't control though. Now Bennison. Had to think about the hit. Decided to play the pass. It was a pass that Hope couldn't control. Aston Villa get the ball away. It's been rather frantic in the early stages here. Two very technical teams. Both trying to unpick the lock. It was cool. Seeing more and more of the ball for Everton. Now Bennison, she's going for it, and that is a brilliant catch by Anna Leet. Well, Bennison scored a beauty against Manchester City in the Barclays Women's Super League. Looked as though that was going wide. Anna Leet was there just to make sure. Maz Pacheco under pressure quickly manages to make the pass. Looked as though she was about to lose the ball. Salmon has given the ball away here. Everton on the run. Snus trying to hold up, trying to find support, unable to find a teammate, but she's won it back. Snus into Bennison. Everton trying their luck on the left-hand side. Stenovic, who was so unlucky in that game against Chelsea in the quarter-finals of the FA Cup, crashed one against the bar from the free kick. Once Chelsea got that goal, they sat back, made it very difficult for Everton to create many clear-cut chances, but Brian Sorensen's team definitely had their chances in that game. Van Avermaet into Piemonte, who is unable to connect with Bennison. There is a really creative look to this Everton midfield here with Bennison alongside Kuhl. And at the moment, that's where the battle is. Everton are well known for going through the phases, going through that central area to build their attacks. Plenty of work to do then for Jordan Nobbs in there. Lucy Hope can't get beyond the sliding Maz Pacheco. Everton get the throw in, which Garley will take. Belgian international Van Avermaet. Over to Finnegan. Everton through and through. On to Garley. Searching ball forward, was looking for her compatriot. Piemonte, who was making the run. Clever ball, but was just unable to connect with Piemonte. Garley started the game pretty deep, advancing more and more. And this is good pressure from Everton. Kuhl can't find a way beyond Darley. And Ebony Salmon brings the ball away and loses it almost instantly. Hasn't really Ebony Salmon been able to make the kind of impact that you would imagine Aston Villa were hoping for this season. Had a really good spell with Bristol City in the Barclays Women's Super League. between 2019 and 2021. 11 goals across the two seasons, but just hasn't been that way in the Barclays Super League for Ebony Salmon, as Bennison wins a free kick for the late challenge by Dan Turner. Well, the referee fairly lenient. No yellow card for Turner. And as the referee's back was turned, the Everton players tried to move the ball further forward by about 2 or 3 yards. And that was well spotted. So finally, we will get this free kick, and it will be hammered straight into the wall after all of that. Stenovec, who hit one so finely against Chelsea, onto the bar. This time runs into the Aston Villa wall. Daly in that midfield trying to turn the ball on. One back by Everton, and it will be struck here by the dangerous Garley. Takes a deflection on the way through. You just never know with her. ...35 yards from goal, Aurora Garley, but we have seen some special hits from her across this campaign. Hasn't been too much work for either goalkeeper to do just yet in this one. Everton looking to change that here. Everton corner delivered deep. Well, it looked as though Finnegan was about to race in and meet that one. Just misses it. Maybe just missed time the run. As Pacheco just one down for Daly to send away. Adriana Leon, who's just come back from the CONCACAF Gold Cup, where she won the top scorer award, unable to control there. 6 goals in 5 games for Canada. And they went all the way to the semi-finals, where they lost out in the end to the United States. But Adriana Leon, who's just won the ball back there. And here she is again, having a brilliant tournament. Scored a goal in the 120th minute. Of the game against the United States to take the game to penalties, the semi-final matchup. Tough team to stop though, the United States. They went through on penalties in the end. as Pacheco finds some room behind her where Dan Turner was waiting. And it's Pacheco again who rolls one around the corner for Daly to chase. Daly up against Bennison, gets away from her, drives into the area, there's the cutback, and there's the interception. Well dealt with back there by Garley. She turns and moves into midfield. And here is Wheeler, who's had to play a number of roles this season, given the injuries in the Everton camp, in a more familiar position in the centre of Everton's midfield here. And she's directing traffic, although the ball goes in the opposite direction. Finnegan looks for Van Avermaet. And she travels, lifts one in. It's a bit too close, though, to Aston Villa's goalkeeper, Anna Leet. And it's an easy catch in the end for the goalkeeper. Bennison stealing possession, takes it off of the toes of Maz Pacheco. Been a slow start so far from Aston Villa in what has been an underwhelming season from them so far. Last season they were the talk of the Barclays Women's Super League after finishing fifth. Went to the semi-finals of the FA Cup, but they really started to take it to the teams at the top end of the Barclays Women's Super League table. Hasn't really been the case across this campaign. Garley looking for that ball in behind. And Lucy Hope has gone down here. Well, she just clashes with Noelle Moritz. And it looks like it's a clash of hips in a season where Everton have really struggled with injuries. Even before this game, Brian Sorensen was talking about those and the lack of consistency that Everton have had as a result. Brian Sorensen there in your picture, talking about Manchester City specifically more recently. You only have to look at their team and how that team has looked mostly the same across the campaign. And then you look at Everton, and it has been a very different story, and that consistency does make a big difference. Carla Ward had plenty to say during that break to her team as well. And it's perhaps no surprise it hasn't been a blistering start here. And in fact, Rachel Daly has been, for the most part, a spectator in this match. There's been next to no service for her. Lucy Hope back onto the field for Everton. Restored to 11 players. Daly turns. Daly was close by. Bennison on the chase as Pacheco comes forward, as she loves to do on this left-hand side. And now Nobbs. Nice build-up. And Daly was looking for the 1-2 on the edge of the penalty area. The ball never comes back to her. Doesn't get the return pass. Courtney Brosnan, who's been pretty quiet in this game so far, can roll away. Everton fans doing their best to rouse the troops. And it may just have done the trick here. Snuis is away. Might need a helping hand. And needed to play a better pass. Rolls that one out of play. Aston Villa throwing. It's Piemonte. holds the ball up nicely. Deep delivery into the area, overhit, out of play, out for a goal kick. Here comes Pacheco, trying to drive into that central space, but she was well looked after by the recovering Gali. Lots of tidy, pretty football from Everton. Nothing too testing at the other end for Anna Leet, though. Here is Stenovic. Everton waiting for the Aston Villa players to arrive here, looking to draw them forward. Daly seems pretty eager to go, but the others, Leon and Salmon, just waiting for their moment. Bennison goes centrally, finds Hope. And cool spins. Stenovic into Bennison. Trying to move Aston Villa around here. And she's done well to roll away from Daly. But then cool can't turn, not with Rachel Daly there. And it will be Daly who can carry the ball away. So brilliant last season, the French international had such an excellent campaign that she missed out, Daly, on the start of the season, and perhaps that lack of pre-season has had a big impact on her, has looked a shadow of her former self and hasn't scored in the Barclays Women's Super League this season, Kenza Daly. And squares the pass, and Mailing is there, trying to turn one forward. Well, we are 25 minutes into the game, and we've not really seen an attack from Aston Villa of any note. Been the story, really, of this campaign. Last season, Hansen, Daly, Lehmann and Nobbs. made such a difference. And just looking at the numbers, in the Barclays Women's Super League last season, Hanson, Darley, Lehman and Nobbs scored 21 goals and had 19 assists. This season, 2 goals in the Barclays Women's Super League between them and 2 assists. Lehman on the bench today, and Hanson is away with an injury that she picked up in that game against Arsenal in the Conti Cup. The returning Adriana Leon and Ebony Salmon, who's the new face in the lineup, have been unable to make an impact on this one so far. Ball is floated over the top here. Salmon has a look before playing the cross. Van Avermaet's back there, smashes into her own teammates and forced into the save. Courtney Brosnan keeps Aston Villa out. Daly looking to inject some tempo into what has been a pretty timid Aston Villa performance so far. This was the chance. Excellent work by Ebony Salmon here, but it was the clearance that caused the problem. And Leon was there, but so too was Courtney Brosnan. Pacheco was in a really good position, but the referee has stopped play here, as is the protocol. Head injury, and therefore a stoppage. The referee really shouldn't have to explain why, but Aurora Garley went down, and again, I'm not sure that there was any malice in the decision. Looks as though both players are watching the ball. As a result, the collision happened and Garley was caught. She continues here to be looked over. And Piemonte, fellow Italian, comes across to see if she's okay. Brian Sorensen just thinking things through. Was very disappointed, Brian Sorensen, after the FA Cup defeat to Chelsea, because they really did have a chance in that game. Everton, they ran Chelsea very close, which isn't something that often happens when you face Emma Hayes' side. Well, good news for Everton. The goalie is back up onto her feet. And she comes to the side of the field here. It looks as though she'll be coming straight back on. Everton will try to defend for the moment with just 10 on the field. Ball is headed away in the middle by Van Avermaet. Dali is back onto the field and Brosnan has the ball in her arms, rolls away. The Republic of Ireland international, who looks as though she will have a tough qualification group for Euro 2025 in Switzerland. France and England in the group for Republic of Ireland. Those games, those qualification matches starting in April. Aston Villa finding their rhythm. After a slow start, they are starting to put together the passes here. And Pacheco makes her way into the area. Well, she did really well to weave between the two Everton players, but then the pass was too heavy for Adriana Leon, who has switched across towards this left-hand side, having started the game camped out on the right. That's a good hustle by Everton to win the ball back. Everton may be disappointed that when they were a bit more in control in this game, they didn't create the chances to punish Aston Villa. And now they're on the back foot again here as Pacheco comes forwards. Heavy touch from her, and that's intercepted by Wheeler and sent on its way. Van Avermaet's pass. Katia Snuis, who's had a quiet afternoon so far, makes her run. Scored two against Aston Villa in the FA Cup earlier on in the campaign, back in January. Had a really good season last season, Katia Snuis. Hasn't quite reached those levels in this campaign. Nice build-up here, Stenovec on the run. And Snuis was there to receive the pass. That was overhit. She's still chasing this one down here, and she very nearly won the ball as well. Mailing able to do just enough. Aston Villa get slightly lucky at the back. There is Pacheco. Been spending a lot more time over the last 10 minutes or so in positions like this, and Aston Villa again will attack on the left-hand side. Has made a big difference with Adriana Leon moving across towards the left. This time she can't connect with Maz Pacheco, who made the run. And Everton will get the goal kick. Finnegan at the back, who no doubt will be looking forward to the Merseyside derby at Goodison. Big Everton fan, but has also scored twice in the Merseyside derby over the last couple of seasons. Scored in the game against Liverpool earlier on in the campaign. Everton winning a free kick here for the challenge on Piemonte. Oh, Patton was late this time. Perhaps a surprise that the referee didn't go to the book. Both Patton and Turner at the back for Aston Villa have come in late with challenges to bring down Everton players that have resulted in free kicks. Yes, Grisgali. Tried that ball a few times, Everton. That ball in behind, looking for the run of Piemonte. Hasn't quite worked out. Nice turn by Hope. And Hope is brought down as she tries to advance. And Everton take it quickly. Here is Bennison. Only succeeds in finding Nobbs, who is there, able to steal the ball back for Aston Villa. And then Pacheco. Well, somehow, by hook or by crook, managed to win the ball. And Dali was there for support, although the pass back into a more defensive position wasn't exactly one that Dan Turner wanted. Instantly, she was put under pressure. And Everton get the throw in here on this near side touchline. Here is Hope. Gets beyond Turner, but Turner looks over her shoulder and sees Jordan Nobbs, an experienced England midfielder. 71 caps for England now. There to tidy things up for Aston Villa. Well, it was all a bit predictable from Aston Villa. And Rachel Daly unable to turn. And here is Piemonte. Holds the ball up, finds Bennison. Scurrying around in midfield, trying to create something here. Looking for that killer pass. Doesn't quite work out for Everton either. It's been a game where two teams have cancelled each other out for the most part. There was one save for Courtney Brosnan, who managed to deny Adriana Leon. There was a long-range effort too that Anna Leet had to save at the other end, although it did look as though it was going wide, but so far a game of very few chances. 6 minutes to go until the break. Daly has spent plenty of time today dropping really deep, trying to get something going. Combines with Nobbs here, and Pacheco is away on the left. Dali just turns a bit too slowly, really. Bennison sliding in. And Pacheco again is forward on this left-hand side. Swiss international, Noah Moritz. And Pacheco again, looking for the run. And finding Leon, who delivers. Unable to pick out Ebony Salmon, who was waiting in the middle. And it's an easy gather in the end for Courtney Brosnan. Go! Well, that was a late challenge, this time by Moritz. And again, the referee is lenient, but we have seen that challenge from Patton Turner. And now from Moritz. Similar kinds of challenges. Well, it's rare to hear the crowd here so quiet. And seem fairly relaxed about the whole thing. That's his nurse trying to ride the challenges. With a foul throw-in. Well, Rachel Daly here doesn't exactly look in good shape. Well, there didn't seem to be initially too much of a problem, but she's gone down there. And it was hard to tell whether that was the knee or the ankle. What's your lip reading like? Gali giving the instructions to Piemonte. Another showing here. It didn't really look to be too serious initially with the challenge, but Rachel Daly's not exactly a player that would stay down unnecessarily. Well, she hobbles to the side. Possibly the challenge with Snuis caused more of a problem than she thought initially. Aston Villa today already without Van Domselaar, already without Hansen. Might be about to lose Rachel Daly. You would imagine she would at least try and walk it through until half-time. We're on the 45. And there will be a minimum of 5 minutes added to the end of this first half. We had the head injury that happened to Gali earlier on in the match, and then the breaking play for Daly. Finnegan's ball into Bennison. Bennison pass. Well, her pass was overcooked. Daly sending one through. Leon couldn't do too much with it. Pacheco couldn't get there because Courtney Brosnan was onto that pretty quickly. Everton on the attack. Piemonte looking for room, finding some, getting the shot away. She sees it blocked, and Daly, who is back there, is able to pass away. FA player tomorrow, Manchester United's game kicking off at 12 against Bristol City. Also got Liverpool against West Ham for you. And then at 2, Tottenham Hotspur against Leicester City is the game that you can catch in the Barclays Women's Super League. We'll also have action for you in the Women's Championship at 2 o'clock of Southampton against Reading. Neither side looking to concede before the half-time whistle, managing the game and making sure it stays like this as we head into the break. Piemonte crowded out as she tries to turn. This game has had a really similar feel to the game against West Ham that Everton played, where in the second half they really came to life. And it was a completely different contest. Both West Ham and Everton were pretty evenly matched in the first 45 minutes. And that's definitely been the case here. I was expecting an extra minute, but the whistle goes. And at half-time, the scoreline is 0-0. And both teams in the second half need to do more to try and challenge the opposition goalkeeper if 3 points is desired. Everton 0, Aston Villa 0 at the break. Let's have a look back at the highlights of the first half. Well, not too much in the way of goal-mouth action. This was a chance for Bennison, which he fired in from just outside of the area. It did look as though it was going wide, but Leek made sure and made the stop. Everton did start the game really well. They were the stronger of the two. And when Garley wound up, you wondered what she might be able to do, given what she has done over the course of the season. But from the resulting corner, Everton unable to do too much. This was Aston Villa's best opportunity to score. It fell to Leon, who was so good at the CONCACAF Gold Cup. Top scorer there, unable to beat Courtney Brosnan with that chance. And otherwise, the link-up from both Everton and Aston Villa just hasn't been good enough. Credit to the two defences in the first half. Everton 0, Aston Villa 0 at the break.
I'm Amy Rogers.
I'm Ali Testro.
I'm Taylor Hines.
I'm Mackenzie Arnold.
I'm Missy Bokens.
And this is the Away Day Teammates.
My away game essentials are my PlayStation. I've got one of the Poga things, so I bring that with me. It's got a TV on so I can play on the coach and stuff.
iPad.
My iPad for Netflix,
Yeah.
Recently, my book I've been into reading now, so any book that I'm reading at the minute.
I like having my AirPods, I can listen to music.
Me too. I'd say like a coffee, but yeah, I went to get like essentials.
AirPods.
My boots, my shin pads.
I mean, obviously my boots. Game day sports bra, grip socks.
My Carmex.
Yeah, maybe just all my toiletries. I like to feel fresh all the time on my perfumes.
I think hairbrush. I've got quite frizzy hair at the front.
A lot of people like to have a pillow for the long journeys. Yeah. So you can sleep with it.
Nothing special.
People might not believe me, but on the coach, I like sitting on my own, playing on my PlayStation and stuff. I do get up and have a wander and socialise with the rest of the girls, but on the coach, I like my own space.
I like sitting next on my own. but I sit around the same group of people, like Yana, Lawsy, but yeah, I like sitting on my own, but I don't mind who I sit opposite with, because we've got tables. So like, as long as I've got the two seats to myself, then I'm happy.
Kirsty Smith.
Yeah, Amy. We've been on one-way trips so far, but I'll keep it that way.
Okay.
I'm satisfied.
Yeah. Okay, perfect.
And I'd say bye.
Jazz and Fernie?
Yeah.
They like a card game.
Yeah.
We've already been enlisted into their card group. So.
Yeah.
Probably Viv and Hawa, always.
I think me and Enderby, I think. We're always up to something.
Stick little things in people's nose when they're sleeping and stuff, or something like that. She'll come up with something. I don't know what it will be, but she'll make it up.
Always late. No one's really late. I would say the last to get ready most of the time would be Shannon Cook.
Let me think, do you know what? No, we're actually all pretty on time.
Everyone's on time?
Yeah. We've only had a few bus journeys though at the minute, so ask me again in a few months.
Okay, well, I don't think anyone has been late, but I will say Brooke is very forgetful, I have come to learn.
Yeah.
So I feel like if there anyone would be late, it would be Brooke, just because she like forgot something or
lost her phone again.
Yeah, lost her keys, something like that.
Probably Bo. Missy Bo, she'll just talk the whole time, and sometimes I just need to like, if I'm gonna read my book, I can't sit next to her because she'll be talking to me.
Princess Viv and Hawa, the whole time.
Jamie Lee.
Or Abby, maybe.
Or Abby,
yeah. The Scots.
To be fair, a few players. I'd say Niamh sleeps a bit.
Risa or Honu.
Niamh Fahey, she's always sleeping. She's not lazy, but she likes her own space and sleeping on the bus.
Not quite sure yet, but Emily Sam does fall asleep.
Does she?
Yeah, she can sleep anywhere.
I say even I might have a little nap, but yeah, a few people do, to be fair.
My best pre-game snack would probably be either 3 Weet-Bix or Weetabix, whatever you want to call them, butter on toast, I'm not gonna lie.
I like to have a banana. I feel like I've been starting that now, like having a banana, give me a bit of energy and stuff, but I always have the same pre-match meal as well. Poached egg on toast, always.
I love porridge before a game, or like overnight oats. I think that's the best thing.
I don't really have a snack, but my pre-match meal's beans on toast, and if it's a night game, I'll have tuna pasta.
I like making sure I'm getting a lot of carbs pre-game.
Post-game snack? A wrap, maybe? I'm a sucker for a milkshake, some sort of chocolate milkshake or something, but yeah, I'm not really, it doesn't faze me, to be honest.
Post-game, I don't know, something that also fills you up, but maybe is a bit less bland than like chicken and rice or something. Treat yourself a little bit.
Yeah, treat me.
Probably like a pizza or something. Our S&C puts food on sometimes after games and we always moan.
Something grubby. So it'd probably have to be Macca's. The coffee trip, probably myself.
We're not allowed to go to Costa no more because Kerry only likes Starbucks.
I mean, I feel like we would like to.
Yeah, we're both coffee drinkers.
Yeah, but we're not very like, we don't know much about the area
yet.
So we're getting a lot of recommendations, but I feel like in a couple months
we've got it.
Is my internet ring, ring, ring,
and I'm
just
good.
Like
just a week ago.
Right, we've got 5 songs here that you have chosen.
Yeah.
A little bit of a soundtrack to your life that we're going to go through.
Uh-huh.
Then we're going to start off with Kalani, Cardi B.
Oh, this is a banger.
Ring. Are you a big Cardi B, Kalani fan in general?
Yeah, definitely, for sure. I think, so this song I always play before a game.
Oh, okay.
So that's kind of like my hype song. Like,
I mean, it's not the most hype.
No,
part,
it's not,
like,
but
it's chilled.
It's chilled.
Yeah, okay.
Like it calms me, it's chilled, I'm relaxed. Yeah. But every game, since it came out, without fail, like imagine.
So do you have a specific game playlist that you like focus on that doesn't cross paths with your life playlist?
Probably. I'd say there's a couple of songs here and there.
Yeah.
That is the top most important.
Yeah.
Like, if I'm like rushing and I haven't listened to it yet, like I'll sit there in the change room with my headphones in.
So it's always become like a superstition now.
Yeah,
you have
probably
to listen to that.
Yeah, before you. If Carla's speaking, I'm like, one sec. Just have it in the background, Cardi B rapping.
Talk me through this.
Love, love, love. I just think it reminds me of my mum. I don't know why. It's just like
obviously their playlist back in the day, that old school R&B vibes. I think just living in that era would be kind of cool.
Are you an old school R&B fan?
I am, big old school R&B fan.
And then if we go into slightly more new school R&B, got a bit of Post Malone.
So, did you watch this film?
I did, yeah, Into the Spider-Verse.
Yeah. As soon as I like put it on, straight away just noticed the playlist.
So good.
It's unbelievable.
So,
like the
so
songs
good.
That were playing, yeah. I think, when you were like, playlist to my life, I'm thinking, that's probably my intro to my life.
Okay, why would you say that?
Just like with how it comes in, it's upbeat, it's chilled.
Yeah.
I feel like that's me.
This one's
definitely on there.
This is a personal favourite of mine, so I'm so glad. Because I don't think anyone else has chose Childish Gambino, actually.
No
I think
way.
You're the first one.
I could put so many of his on there.
Love him.
This song, not that I forgot, but I remembered it when I was in Australia watching the Women's World Cup.
Yeah.
And just being in Australia, sunset, sunrise. Blue skies, you got the beach.
Yeah.
This song banging.
Yeah.
What more could you want?
And then back to our old school R&B, an absolute classic.
What is so, one fact.
Yeah.
That was top of the charts on my birth when I was born. So
there's a bit of a story behind it as well.
So then I was like, do I put that at the start of my life? Because that's the day I was born.
Yeah.
It was number one in the UK.
That's a good one to have. Because
so,
other people, like when you look at like the one, like what was number one when they were born and it was like some terrible song.
Yeah.
And you're like,
oh, I know.
That's a good one.
And when
that's
it's this one, I'm like, their boy is. I'm like, easy.
If you were to, do a duet of that karaoke, who of your teammates are you choosing to do the other part?
Do you know what? I'd pick Rachel Daly. She is a karaoke guru.
Yeah.
I think she wouldn't disappoint.
Do you think she's got that in her locker? Monica.
I feel like we need 10 out of 10 effort,
yeah,
and she would provide the 10 out of 10 effort.
Yeah.
So that's all I'm going to rate her on.
Fair enough. maybe not a big like
fan
herself, but she'll put the effort.
Yeah, we'll see if we do it one day.
And then out of these songs, you've just won a game. Which of those five are you playing to celebrate, get everyone going, have a good time?
Oh, probably Post Malone.
Okay.
Chilled.
Yeah.
I'd probably play Ring, I'm lying. I'd probably play Kanye, Kalani. Yeah, I'm lying.
And everyone's like, this again, man.
That's why I'm not allowed on the speed. That's probably why I'm not allowed. I have like three songs.
To see us out, could you give us one line of Ring Ring? I feel like you got the vocals on.
Oh.
Little one. Ring,
ring, ring.
There you go. That's all we need. That's all we need. Perfect. Cool. Thank you for giving us your choices.
No problem.
I'm going to add these to my playlist now.
Yeah, sick. Thank you.
Rachel Furness, and this is my ultimate five-a-side. So, in goal, I'd say Mary Earps, played with Art Redden. World's best keeper right now, so Mary. I think she was fantastic at the World Cup and showed why she's one of the best goalkeepers around. So Mary. I mean, I guess I need a defender in there too if I don't concede. Current centre-half, I'd say Millie Bright. Fantastic leader for Chelsea. Really, really tough to play against. Really physical, great on the ball. Zero goals conceded. Happy days. Kim Little, a midfielder that I've always looked up to and thought has been fantastic for Arsenal over the years. A really kind of unsung hero, but one of the hardest players I've played against. So Kim Little, 100% in there. I need to score goals, so I'll say Beth Mead. Played with her at Sunderland back when she was just normal old Beth. Knew she was a kind of superstar back then, so yeah, definitely Beth in there. Viv, Miedemar, I'd have to put in there. Her and Beth link up well. Yeah, fantastic player. I mean, a goat of the WSL, scores a lot of goals.
big hello to George Brown and Cole Mitchell. It's their first time here today at Walton Hall Park.
Welcome back for the second half here of Everton against Aston Villa. Neither side's really causing too much trouble in the opposition penalty area in the first half. There were chances, just not many of them. Some final words from both players before they get themselves back underway here. Everton will get us started here at Walton Hall Park in the second half. Looking to make this their second home win of the season. And we are started, and it's Everton who get us going. Annelie had very little to do for Aston Villa at the back in the first half. There was one save, but it was one that looked as though it would have been going wide. In any case, the New Zealand international making sure best chance of the game, probably falling to Adriana Leon. But it was a save that you would have expected a goalkeeper of Courtney Brosnan's calibre to make. Smith unable to turn. And interesting to see Rachel Daly back on the field. She was hurt at the end of the first half. She's a tough cookie, though, she continues. And the England international continues to be very deep for Aston Villa. It has been Ebony Salmon and Adriana Leon who have been the two players furthest forward for Aston Villa. And Piemonte giving the ball away. Aston Villa get the throw in here, which will be taken by Sarah Maley. Poole doesn't control. Aston Villa charging. Salmon leading the way. It's Ebony Salmon who winds up. Only to see the shot well blocked by Everton inside the penalty area. Now, Anna Patton is the only one to start every single game in the Barclays Women's Super League for Aston Villa this season, which perhaps just demonstrates how much they have suffered with injury across the campaign. Nobbs working the ball around in midfield, and here is Darley. Daly's touch. And Leon will chase, and she won't get there. Everton trying to make some progress along the right hand side. Hope was unable to bring the ball under control. Interestingly, you look towards the two benches for both Everton and Aston Villa today, and you do start to wonder in a 0-0 game about game changers. Everton's bench has very little experience. There are, amongst the Aston Villa substitutes, a couple of players that you may be would consider to be game changers. Alicia Lehman and Freya Gregory sticking out in particular. And substitutes are all the more important this season, with so many minutes now being added to the end of games. It's not really a 90-minute match anymore. It's certainly a 100-minute game, maybe more than that. Benison with a touch into Piemonte. And in there to win it back. Here's Rachel Daly. Pass away by Leap. Very nearly got Aston Villa in trouble, but it's a nice drop of the shoulder by Noel Moritz, and Aston Villa can bring the ball away. Leon can't turn, can't get beyond Stenebeck. And she's able to travel out towards this left-hand side where Snoos is waiting. There was a collision that happened off of the ball. Nobbs was involved, Stenebeck sent to the ground. And Everton get the free kick, and they'll send it back towards Finnegan. Well, Everton fans often have to be patient. The style of football under Brian Sorensen is very structured. They are methodical as they bring it forwards, and happy to go back to try and stretch out the shape of the opponent. Katia Snoos with a good turn. She's going for goal. It takes a deflection, and it very nearly dropped to Piemonte, who was hoping for the pass. Had made a really good run into the channel. The deflection took the sting out of the shot slightly.
Hey! up there and then came from here.
Van Avermaet heavy with the pass. And Hope will not get to that one. Was a bit too heavy for Sarah Mayling, who'd made a really good run out towards this right-hand side, but she won't get to that. It rolls away and out for a goal kick. Well, still, both sides don't seem too eager to give too much away, not taking a chance, no real risks being taken here. His touch. And cool. The Arsenal loanee works it wide. It's Aston Villa who can win it back. Mayling can't make any progress. Well, games like this are often decided by a flash of brilliance, a moment of individual inspiration. And you're looking around this pitch wondering who will be the one to provide it. Happy to go home, where Finnegan waits. Well, the pass into midfield sees Everton dispossessed, and Salmon is away. She won't get beyond the impressive Finnegan, though, who makes the challenge, always so steady at the back for Everton, a real leader. Darley now gets it back from Leon, goes for goal and scores. It's a brilliant strike from Kenza Darley, her first of the season in the Barclays Women's Super League, and it's a special one. Nicely worked by Darley here, edge of the area, the give and go, gets it back from Leon, picks her spot, and the awkward bounce meant that Courtney Brosnan couldn't get there. Brilliant from Kenza Darley. Well, the game comes to life in a flash. And in a game where there haven't been many chances, when they arrive, you really need to take them. And the player to provide that moment, that spark of inspiration, is Kenza Darley. And I'm sure Aston Villa fans will be delighted for her. Hasn't been an easy season with the injury that came at the start of the campaign. And that might just be the confidence boost that she needs. Aston Villa get the free kick. Avermaet's header away. Maz Pacheco is battling with Garley here, but it's Garley that comes away with the ball. Dali again into Nobbs. A bit more tempo all of a sudden about Aston Villa's attacking play. Rachel Daly. Sent wide by Moritz. Into Nobbs. Two former Arsenal players combining. Piemonte's tackle, she's done well to steal it here. And now she needs some support, and it arrives in the shape of Bennison. And there is Garley joining the attack. Aurora Garley delivers the cross, and the momentum of Everton's attack breaks down, and Aston Villa get plenty back and make the clearance. And you feel that Everton perhaps should have done more with that moment. Got themselves into a really good position after excellent work by Piemonte. Wheeler. Oh, that's a clever touch. Hope around the corner. Bennison there, only to see the effort blocked, and then the volley goes wide. A good response to conceding the goal from Everton. Unable to find the target, though. Bennison sees this one well blocked by Patton. And that was pretty far wide in the end. Around the corner to the chasing Leon. Canadian international touching back, looking for Dali again. Making that late run into the area was well spotted. Now Dali. Sometimes hard to put your finger on exactly why Aston Villa have not been able to recreate the form that they've shown last season in this campaign. Just occasionally you get flashes of the old Aston Villa, the one that we saw last season that finished fifth in the table. And they've definitely come to life after the goal from Kenza Dali here in this second half. Nobbs in space. Nobbs feeds it through. Dali there. Looking to create this time. Runs into Hannah Bennison, wins a corner. Receiving the ball. Aston Villa have plenty forward here. Here comes Nobbs, whips one in into the front post, and Aston Villa have two. What a brilliant ball in towards the front post. Superbly met by Ebony Salmon with the header. An excellent second half from Aston Villa. In the space of 15 minutes, they have turned this game on its head. Oh, Jordan Nobbs plays the first part, whipped in, and then a wonderful run from Salmon, who steers it into that far corner quite brilliantly. Well, Ebony Salmon has struggled this season to really make the impact that we thought that she might do here at Aston Villa. Just her second start in the Barclays Women's Super League. But that's a brilliant goal from a young player who, when she first came into the Barclays Women's Super League, was a player that really impressed, particularly with her time at Bristol City. And that's an excellent goal. And a wonderful ball as well from Jordan Nobbs. Scarley sends one through. And it's picked up this time by Courtney Brosnan. Maybe Courtney Brosnan slightly disappointed with the goal, you would feel, the header from Salmon. But it was the perfect header right into that far corner. From close range, at pace, she really used the speed of the ball to guide it into that far corner. Very good goal, difficult to keep out. Piemonte trying to turn. Everton's problems at home continue, just the one win across the campaign in home fixtures. And it looks as though that will remain the same. 28 minutes to turn this one around here. Piemonte is the target, she won't get there. It's a long, hopeful ball and again a collision. And again, the physio team, who have been pretty busy today, will be called onto the field. Ebony Salmon, the scorer of the second goal for Aston Villa. And we can have a look at the two Aston Villa goals that have come in this first half. Lovely combination play here. Kenza Dali with the give and go. Her first goal in the Barclays Women's Super League this season. And it was an absolute peach. Then it's all about how do you follow up after scoring the goal, and they followed up pretty quickly. The initial corner didn't really come to too much here. Relatively easily dealt with by the Everton defence, but then Jordan Nobbs whipped in a brilliant ball and it was superbly met by Ebony Salmon, who arrived. Here come Aston Villa, we're back underway, and here is Leon. Leon trying to turn inside the area, not giving that one up easily. The shot that came in was a pretty decent one from Jordan Nobbs, but there was a foul by Adriana Leon. Piemonte sending one through and looking for Garley, who has won it back here for Everton. Garley with the touch into the middle. It will drop for Piemonte, who's done well, stays on her feet. Aston Villa get back, and Mayling has seen quite enough of that and thumps away. Van Avermaet allowed to travel, looking for Bennison. Aston Villa are looking for the offside flag here. No flag from the assistant. Garley, closed down by Pacheco. Wheeler into Bennison. Room to turn, tries to play the pass. And Dali spotted what was about to happen and gets there first. Daly. Finding Mayling, who has in turn moved the ball onto Leon. And she dribbles away from two, sends in, and it was somewhere between a cross and a shot. It very nearly looped into that far corner. Nice work again from Adriana Leon, who's having a brilliant second half. Thank you. Well, Everton look as though they are about to make a change. First, they will look to build an attack. And it will be Bennison. Now Stenovic. Snowis has done well. She delivers in. Everton looking to respond. And that, perhaps, is their best move of the match. Wonderful work here by Snowis. And the cross was crying out for something better. And here comes the change. And Dale will be the one to come on, replacing Piemonte, which is perhaps a surprise. Bissell coming on too, to replace Lucy Hope.
Number 17, Lucy Hope. Her replacement, number 11, Emma Bissell.
Mile Everton hoping that the two changes can make an impact here as they look to get back into the game. Aston Villa will make a double change as well. Well, the goal scorer Ebony Salmon's had a brilliant afternoon, and there will be a warm reception for former Everton player Simone McGill, who comes on as her replacement. Freya Gregory also onto the field. Could be another attacking threat here for Aston Villa. Well, Ebony Salmon off of the field can be pretty happy with her performance here. A goal to perhaps bring some confidence. Leon's touch here, finding Mailing. And there's a big appeal from Aston Villa, and in particular, Adriana Leon, who feels that she was pulled back. And the referee had the same feeling. And that will be a yellow card for Stenovic. Kenza Dali, who scored the brilliant opening goal in this game. Lining one up here for Aston Villa. And only succeeds in finding an Everton head in the middle, but there are more problems to worry about as Aston Villa send it back into the danger zone. Rachel Daly was unable to hook it back around the corner. And the whistle blows for an Everton free kick. That's the reason for the yellow card for Stenovic. Chance to chase for Bissell, who won't get there ahead of Mailing, who can sweep that one away. Everton are crying out for somebody to be a game changer for them here. Just as Dali was, who set the tone for Aston Villa in this second half. Confirmation of the substitutes for you in your top left-hand corner. Off go Aston Villa again. Trey Gregory on the chase and delivering. Gave Courtney Brosnan something to think about. Darley runs into Benison. Easily dealt with though by Aston Villa. Here is Stenovec. Stenovec's deep cross. And Lee doesn't deal with that particularly well. And the challenge inside the penalty area sees Dale go down, and she doesn't look entirely comfortable here. It was a dangerous cross, and there's relief for Anna Leet, who didn't get that. Here's Bissell. Bissell's pass. Manages to pick out Stenovec. Well, something for Everton clearly has to change, because this season they've really struggled to score goals, and in this game and across the campaign they've struggled to create the chances. Brian Sorensen clearly has a way of playing, a style that he adheres to, but possibly that needs to be adapted. I'm sure Everton will be looking for new recruits in the summer. Everton do have a corner. And in a game where they really haven't created very much, it's from moments like this that they really need to try and pounce. Whipped in towards the front post, and Daly deals with that and gets rid. Another physio team are coming on again here, not for the first time in the game. Well, Rachel Daly is down, but she is now back up, and the physio team will make their way back to the side of the pitch. Everton corner. And it's a good grab by Leet. Chance for Aston Villa to break. And it's McGill against her old side, making the burst. Made over 150 appearances for Everton. Unable to find a teammate as she made the burst. And Everton able to win the free kick. They were trying to take it quickly, and that's not really surprising, but the referee halting play here. Katia Snuis, the latest player down. Into the final 10 minutes. Have Everton got something in the locker here to try and challenge Aston Villa? Benison scored a brilliant goal against Manchester City in the Barclays Women's Super League not so long ago. She was unable to advance. Everton will start again from the back. And there hasn't really been a player today that's really looked like troubling Aston Villa at the back. Aston Villa are set to make a few more changes here. And Kenza Darley, who scored a brilliant goal to get things going for Aston Villa, will be removed for the final 10 minutes here to be replaced by Taylor. Her first goal in the Barclays Women's Super League this season. Set the tone and looks as though it set Villa up nicely for 3 points here. Flash of the old Kenza Darley, who is removed after such a good performance. And Georgia Mullet also coming in and will be replacing here the top goal scorer in the CONCACAF Gold Cup this season, Adriana Leon. Another who had a really good second half. And Mullet comes on in her place. Darley has won it back here for Everton. She delivers, brilliant ball. And wasn't too far away from connecting with Snuis, who'd made a really good run as well. Well, we talk about fine margins all the time in football, and that's really been the difference here. Everton's passes just haven't quite made it. And Jordan Nobbs, well, her pass certainly did make it for the Ebony Salmon goal. Everton's cross is turned away, and then it's thumped into Everton's half. And that's really all Aston Villa need to do. Sounds simple, might not be. Could be a stressful end to this game as Everton push and push and look for a route back into the match. Daly continues to play deep. Adds an extra body in that midfield. Aston Villa definitely safe in the Barclays Women's Super League. I don't think there's really any danger. Well, there certainly wasn't coming into this match of them being considered as a team that would be involved in the relegation scrap. But every single manager will tell you that it's nice to finish the season strongly. It gives you momentum for the new campaign, and that's what Aston Villa will be looking for. Last season, this Aston Villa team were very fired up with thoughts of the World Cup coming up. Nobbs and Daly very much playing for their place within that team. Well, next season, we've got Euro 2025 looming. Maybe there will be a bit more charge and a bit more energy about the Aston Villa performances as a result. Sent in, lifted in, and Everton have scored. Lee came to claim and got nowhere close to the ball. Well, it was a rather hopeful ball into the box, but Everton get the vital touch. It's a wonderful header from Stenovec who gets there before Aston Villa's goalkeeper, Anna Leeds. Everton 1, Aston Villa 2. Well, Everton have created very little in this game, but all of a sudden, they are back in it after an excellent second-half performance from Aston Villa. Aston Villa concede. Everton give themselves a chance. And now the final 5 minutes plus a considerable amount of injury time could be pretty stressful for Aston Villa fans here. Trying to turn, Dale had two for company. Daly's pass around the corner. Off goes Mullet here. Her cross intercepted, but not completely dealt with by the Everton defence. Aston Villa still pushing. Brosnan nearly dropped it too. Taylor is denied, though, by Everton's goalkeeper. Well, it will be a bit frantic now, given the scoreline. There is absolutely no reason, though, for Everton not to throw everything at this in an attempt to grab themselves a point. It's Aston Villa, though, who look to break away. Mullet leads the way. Aston Villa have a corner. Mailing to take. Mailing's curling ball into the front post. doesn't lead to a chance. Snurs was trying to control, stumbled as she tried to do that, and Nobbs was able to do what she needed to do. 2 minutes of regular time remaining, expecting at least 5 minutes of additional time. Stenovic, the goal scorer, feeding forward. Kuhl couldn't get to the resulting deflected clearance away. And Van Avermaet can't bring that one under control. And Everton will make a change. Katrin Kuhl, the Arsenal loanee, will be removed. And Isabella Hobson comes on. 16 years old, the youngest Everton player to play in the Barclays Women's Super League. Onto the pitch, Everton not the only team to make a change. One coming up here for Aston Villa. Rachel Daly, who's had one of her quieter afternoons, is replaced by the Scotland international, Rachel Corsi. Rachel Corsi, 34 years old, still very much thinking about the European Championships in Switzerland next year. Qualification games kicking off in April. Onto the field here as a defensive reinforcement for Aston Villa, who are looking to shore things up at the back, looking to keep it tight as we head into additional time. Looked as though they had the job done, but Everton have punched back. Well, not for the first time in the game, Katia Snus is penalised for a foul throw-in. Shouldn't really be happening at this level. Minimum of 6 minutes then to be added. Gregory can't stop the cross, getting into the area. There's a whistle and Everton players are completely mystified as to why. But it will be an Aston Villa free kick. And it's perhaps no surprise that Aston Villa are not in a rush to take this. Although the referee is just letting Annelieke know that the watch is stopped. Benison's touch. Stenovic's long, hopeful ball was nearly perfect. Van Avermaet has gone from playing at the back to being positioned slightly further forward here. Has that aerial presence to cause problems. And she will be the target again. And she'll get the touch as well. Was looking for the run of Bissell, trying to get in behind, but unable to do that. Run. She's lost possession. And now Aston Villa will just try and keep the ball at this end of the field. Into the corner it goes. Courtney Brosnan not taking any risks. Everton have time, not much time, but they do have 3 minutes to try and bring this game level. Garley provided the cross for Stenovec, who supplied the goal for Everton to give them a chance in this match. And again, it will be a long, hopeful ball forward from her. And again, it will be a big header away, this time by Patton. There was a pullback. Hobson was trying to progress. Young Everton player who was so delighted to make that first ever appearance in the Barclays Women's Super League, who Everton thinks so highly of, makes her way forward having won the free kick. Garley's done it once, provided the first goal for Everton. Can she do it again from here? Might be Everton's best chance to pull themselves level. Garley delivers, looking for the glancing header. Well, there was a big shout from the Everton fans for a handball. The referee gives the free kick in the opposite direction. Well, Brian Sorensen felt that Everton could have had a penalty in the game against Chelsea in the FA Cup quarter-final. It'll be an Aston Villa free kick. Bennison. We head towards the final minute of the game. Bissell can't do too much with the pass. Has to go backwards, really. Hobson looking for the flick on. Thumped away by Aston Villa. Hobson came to meet it, taken off of her head by Mullet. Stenovic's heavy touch and a late challenge as well. She's already on a yellow card and she might be about to go. Stenovic's second yellow card of the game and Everton are reduced to 10 players. The referee had a long, hard think, but it always felt as though that red was coming, and that should, near enough, take Aston Villa to the final whistle. Aston Villa managed to hold on here. And thanks to a brilliant second half performance, they grab all 3 points. Darley set them on their way. Salmon grabbed the second after a brilliant cross into the area from Jordan Nobbs. There was a late fight back, but it came a bit too late from Everton. And it finishes here, Everton 1, Aston Villa 2. Here are the highlights of this afternoon's game. Well, there were very few chances in the first half. The best of them fell to Adriana Leon, a good stop by Courtney Brosnan, but the two teams really cancelled each other out. In the second half, Everton had the chance here with Piemonte in a good position to maybe do a bit more, but it was Aston Villa who linked up quite brilliantly on the edge of the box to give us the breakthrough. Kenza Darley with her first goal in the Barclays Women's Super League this season. And it was a brilliant one at that. Fired into the bottom corner by the French international, and the second goal wasn't too far behind. Everton really didn't create enough that was clear cut, and Aston Villa were given the chance to break. The initial corner and cross didn't really lead to too much, but then England international Jordan Nobbs with a fine delivery and a wonderful connection from Ebony Salmon, who was there, flashing the header into the far corner, and it was the goal that mattered for Aston Villa in the end. Everton responded well. This could perhaps have been the moment for them. Brilliant work by Katia Snooze. Wasn't too long before Garley supplied Stenovec. Stenovec's header gave them a chance, and Everton really pushed in the late stages. Aston Villa had the opportunity to add goal number three, but the third goal never arrived. A good afternoon's work for Carla Ward and her team. Thank you for joining us for this one. Another thoroughly entertaining game in the Barclays Women's Super League. Finishes Everton 1, Aston Villa 2.